So thank you for joining me today, and I begin now my program. I'm so happy to meet all of you, by the way. It gives me great, great happiness to be with amidst all of you wonderful people. And I really wish to do something important for you. I want to tell you about procrastination. And I hope and pray that your time together with me will be very meaningful and productive. Let us see what God has, you know, kept in store for all of us. And now, if you are able to see, I'm going to share my screen with you. Let's begin this important session on breaking out of the comfort zone, dealing with procrastination. As I said, Kali Yuga is an amazing age. You know, this age is the age where you can predict that there will be troubles, there will be problems. Manda sumanda matyo manda bhagyo padrata kalavasman yuge rajan. You know, it is told in the Bhagavad Puran. In this age of Kali Yuga, there are amazing problems and troubles which come to the people. One of the problems is procrastination. Another problem is forgetfulness. What is procrastination? In one line, procrastination means to delay the important tasks, right? To not do them on time or to forget them. You know, to forget them, okay, we forgot it and I could not do it. I did not do it, or I could not do it, or I forgot to do it. So these problems are very common. Once one person approached the doctor, Kali Yuga person approached the doctor, and he said to the doctor, "Doctor, I am suffering from a great disease." By the way, you can keep your videos off if you want, so that there can be seamless streaming of the audio and the slides also. So this Kali Yuga person, he went to the doctor and he said, "Doctor, I have a serious disease. I have a big problem which is going on in my life." The doctor asked, "Okay, what's it? What is the problem which is going on? Tell me." So the patient replied. The patient said that my problem is that I forget. You know, I have a forgetfulness disease. The doctor said, "Okay, really? That's a very common problem. But what exactly do you forget, sir?" So the patient replied, "I forget three things. Three things exactly I forget." The doctor took out his pen and paper and started writing. "Okay, what is it? Did you forget, sir? Please tell me. Accordingly, I'll give you the prescription and medicine." The patient replied, "The first thing which I forget is the names of people. I forget the names of people. You know, it's very common, right? You know, you forget the names of people. You forget somebody whom we met some time before, some days before, some years before, some months before. You know, we need to, nowadays we have to keep pictures. You know, we keep picture in my mobile in case if somebody comes in front, we see, okay, who is this? You know, we also store the name, and in the name itself we put the picture of the person also, isn't it? Because somebody may call, but we forget, oh, what is the name? So we keep the picture in the mobile itself." So he said that, "I forget the names of the people." Very big problem. He said, "Okay, what else do you forget?" The second thing the patient replied, "I forget is the phone numbers of the people." Now that is also a big problem, isn't it? Nowadays we find that people forget their own phone numbers also. They keep it in their the self. They keep their mobile, you know, in case I forget, no, SELF self. They keep it like that. So that is another thing which he forgot. And then the doctor asked, "Okay, what is the other thing which you forget? What is the third thing?" And then there was a silence for about a minute. And the patient was thinking, "What is that which I forget? The third thing." And then the patient replied, "Actually, I forgot, sir. I forgot what I forget." You know, even forgot what he forgets. You know? So this is the age of Kali, where this kind of problems are very common. In case if you see this in your life, that you do procrastination, don't worry, dear friends, you are not alone. There are so many people who procrastinate. Please don't have any shame or something when we are discussing this kind of a talk, that what this procrastination, oh my God, I procrastinate. It is a common problem, and almost everybody probably procrastinates some other time. What is the definition? This is the definition. The definition of procrastination, in case if you do not know it properly, is right in front of you. It says, to delay a higher priority task for no good reason is the definition of procrastination. There are various reasons, but I'm not going into reasons. I'm just first defining what is a problem. Have you not seen this in your own life? And have you not seen it in others' life? And many times, you know, we are delaying that which is exactly so important for us. They're delaying it unnecessarily for no good reason. For example, a student may start delaying their preparation for an exam. So because the exam is, let's say, next week, so there are 7 days, student knows it's important to study the particular subject, but because of no good reason, they keep delaying it. And you know, the habit which we have is that one day before, or maybe one night before, you know, I was in IIT, in IIT Kharagpur, oh my God, how crazy people are sometimes. Just one day before, one night before, they will go around, search around, hey, where is the topper? You know, everybody searching the topper one night before, he's in demand. you know the reason why he's in demand one night before. Because there are so many boys who have not studied anything and they just gherify, as we say, gherify the, you know, the topper, and they would just ask, okay, what is it, which will come in tomorrow's exam, tell me the minimum, tell me not maximum, tell me the minimum by which I will pass, that much only, one night only is remaining. So the habit. We also know, if you are in working in an office, sometimes there's a deadline, and we know for this deadline I need to do 1, 2, and 3 important major tasks, but we keep delaying it. You know, in our own houses also, we have seen in the house also, maybe we have to buy the grocery and we know it's getting over, but until and unless the thing becomes completely over, you know, we don't know. And then we face a trouble, then only we go into it. We know there is a repair at the home, repair has to be done because of the there is a drop by drop, the water is dripping somewhere in the tap, and if we don't repair it, the problem becomes bigger. But we keep delaying it, the important task we delay for no good reason, that's called as procrastination. Right? If you're able to relate with the definition which I am saying in your own way, if you're in your own context, please type yes or okay. Yes, you're able to relate with the definition which I am giving you. You're at least understanding the problem which we are discussing. Yes, please type it down on your chat box. If you're able to understand and if you're able to relate it with your own life, because there are people from all different walks of life. Yes, you're able to relate it. Yes, everybody, please type it. Absolutely. Yes. Yes, sir, it's true. It happens with everyone. Yes, it happens with everyone. It happens. Let's go ahead. The statistics. I want to tell you the statistics, because sometimes people become, you know, afraid that, oh, is it, you know, this problem is so common. I do it every day. Somebody will say, I am not able to relate with it. I do it every day. It happens with me every time, probably, you know. But I want to tell you, therefore, the statistics. Statistics, according to a recent study done in 2020, just before the lockdown, the study was done. Okay, this study was done in 2020. What was the study? According to the statistics, it says that 84% people are affected by procrastination. Okay, how many percent? Yes, 84%. So you're not alone. Okay, fine. You're not alone. 84% people is too much, right? And it also, another research, it says 1 out of 5 people procrastinate. How much times? Every single day of their life. Oh my God. It's really problematic. Okay, it's really problematic. Fine, we know that it's problematic, but now I want to do you tell you 2 ways people mainly procrastinate. This is also important for you to understand. One is by not doing anything. Please see it in front of you, it's right there, you know. One is by not doing anything meaningful. Example, just playing games, or just chit chatting, you know, or just watching the cinema. Nowadays, you have this video, YouTube videos, you just get into the YouTube videos, okay, one after another. You know, or just chilling out, not doing anything meaningful, just playing the video games, or just sleeping. You know, just sleeping. Nowadays, people can sleep also. You know, in our IIT Kharagpur days, I remember there was one boy who slept straight for around 60 hours. He did not wake up only. For two days plus, he was just sleeping, you know. Oh, he did not come out of the room, he did not eat also anything. So, see. So, yes, that's procrastination. When you do not do anything meaningful, you just keep delaying the important activity. Just playing games, maybe video games these days. Just chatting, speaking out, you know, or playing, or just watching movies. And doing something which is not useful for you. You could be doing so many activities. And or sleeping, just sleeping. But there is second thing also which happens, which is also very common. I am sure the students, the people, those of you, you probably may not be falling in first category. You may not be in the first category. Most of the times, only few times you might be there. But the second category is where the biggest problem lies. Please see it. It says that by remaining busy. Yes, we remain busy. Most of you are gentlemen and gentlewomen. You may be busy, but we remain busy in doing the wrong thing. Not the right thing. We do not do the most important work, most important task. We keep delaying it, and we instead spend our time on something else which is easy to do. which is simple to do, which is meaningful for in some way, but it's easy to do. It's not in the direction of that main task and activity which is in front of us, which is most important, but we just don't pay attention on that. Pay attention on something else. This is where the major problem lies. And I think most of you who have come to attend my program today, you probably will be in the second category for maybe 80-90% of the time. Maybe only 10-5% of the time you may be in the first category, which also happens sometimes. But I think for most of you, the real problem lies in the second one. And here is where, please hear attentively. I am going to teach you today how to come out of the second one. The first one is easy to deal with. You know it, you can just overcome it. It's not so difficult. But the second one is more difficult. I'm going to teach you about the second one and also some important tips for the first one as well. Okay? So, you know, I'll give you an example. The example for the second type is, let us say a student has maths exam on Monday. And today is Sunday. Next Monday, after 1 week, that means after 8 days, you know, the college exam is there of mathematics. Now, the problem is the mathematics is difficult for most of us, you know, it has been difficult for most of us, you know, even those who are good at it, sometimes the problems are very difficult to solve, right? So maths. So the student, if he is of the second type procrastinator of second type, then what the student will do? It's not that he will not study. It's not that he will sleep. It's not that, you know, he will play games. What he will do? He will study what? English. He will start studying English. What else? He will say computers. He will study what? He will study chemistry. He will study physics. Other than mathematics, he will study everything. You know why this happens? Why this happens? That the student is not wanting to study mathematics, which is the most important task for him. But why is he studying, you know, something else? Because he wants to avoid the difficulty he is going to face in studying maths. Okay, we are going to come to a very important discovery just in next 5 minutes, and you are supposed to pay your attention here. What triggers procrastination in front of you, dear friends? Please see this. When there is an important activity and you get a feeling of discomfort with that activity, as most of you saw, most of you, your responses were there, but this is the real reason. Please understand it. I made you discover it because unless you think about it, you won't understand what I'm speaking. So when there is an important activity and there is a feeling of discomfort associated with it, then is when procrastination happens. Let me tell you a simple example. If I like mathematics, if I like to solve math problems, if I am fond of it, if it triggers me, if it energizes me, if it makes me enthusiastic, it makes me a feeling of, wow, I am going to do it, right? But then I just go and I study mathematics. Maybe in the next week exam is there. Now only I'll complete it, finish it off. You know, no problem. Only when you have a feeling of discomfort, you know, oh my God, I'm going to do that. No. Like that. Understand discomfort? I don't want to do that. I'm not interested in doing that. No. You know, like that. Just like when you have a plate full of nice food and you like something, you will just gulp it. You will just chew it. But when you don't like something, you know what happens? You try to avoid. Okay, I don't want to eat it. Or I don't want to eat it. But somebody forces, what happens? You feel like very discomfort, you know? That's exactly what I'm talking about. When there's a feeling of discomfort associated with the activity, which is important. The problem is it is important. But you have a feeling of discomfort associated with it. That's when procrastination happens. This is the underlying reason. Please see it in your own life. I want you to think about your life. Is it not true? Is it not true that every time you're procrastinating, you're preferring to not do that action? You're preferring to do some other action. Maybe just resting, maybe just lazy, maybe just, you know, relaxing. Only because you feel it is a Mount Everest to climb. Where is the Mount Everest? Mount Everest is not in, you know, not physical Mount Everest. Mount Everest is where? Mount Everest is in the mind. It is a difficult task, therefore you are feeling it as a Mount Everest. And that is why you don't want to climb that Mount Everest. Okay? Fine. But the problem here is the problem, dear friends. Please see this. The problem here is that the feelings of discomfort origin procrastination, but the more you keep procrastinating, the more the feeling of discomfort increases. This is the trap. And here is where the problem lies. And that's what I define as comfort zone. this trap which is going to be made, no, this trap makes you a trap of comfort zone. We are going to talk about comfort zone just in the next 5-10 minutes. Okay, so feelings of discomfort lead to procrastination, but the problem what is, it is a cycle. The more you keep procrastinating, the more you keep delaying that task, the more you keep saying no to that task and saying yes to something else, what happens to you is you keep increasing the feelings of discomfort and it becomes even more difficult to approach that activity, right? People delay for what not reason. Oh my God, they just delay for what not reason. They just want a reason to just delay that important activity. Just any reason. In fact, no good reason. That's what I say. Once one person went to a God. No, he has a problem. He had a problem. He wanted something. He went to God. And he, you know, somehow God came in front of him. No, okay, don't ask me why. This is just a story, right? It's just a story. So God came in front of that man, you know. And then this man, you know, started praying. Oh my God, you're so great. You're so great. There is no problem which you cannot solve. There is no problem which you cannot solve. The God said, yes. Very grave voice, the God said, yes. And then the person said, God, I heard that you are very great. You're very great. Can I know your greatness? Can you please tell me that how much is your 1 paisa? Because it seems like you are so rich. God replied, yes. My 1 paisa is equivalent to billions and billions of rupees. Oh my God. Okay, tell me now that how much is your 1 second? It seems like you live for eternity. God said, yes. I live for eternity and my 1 second is equal to billions and billions of years. Oh my God. That's how much long you live. But now I have a question. Can you please do something for me? I just don't want much. I don't want to trouble you, but I just want your 1 paisa. Can you please give me just 1 paisa? I said, yeah, of course. Can you please wait for 1 second? So that was a googly for the person. Can you wait for 1 second? Now you understand what it means. It means that waiting for billions and billions of years. Thank God that God does not procrastinate. If God starts procrastinating, I mean, what's going to happen? That was just a story to tell. People need any reason or no good reason to just keep procrastinating. Okay, that's not good. But the problem here is what I'm talking about is it's a trap. It's a trap. And let's not get inside the trap. So therefore, what difficulties we face due to procrastination, let's talk about that. Even before we talk about the solution, even before I talk about the next thing which is coming, which is very simple to do, but it will help you a lot. I want you to think about what is the difficulty we face due to procrastination. Can you please type it on your chat box? I want to know from you. Any one of you can please type. I'll just, what I will do is, I'll stop sharing my slides. But and I'll be on my chat box here. If you write, if you write on the chat box, I'm going to put it on my slides. Okay, I'm going to put it on my slides. Please, tell me about what difficulties do we get due to procrastination. Yeah, you're going to tell me what difficulties do we get because of procrastination, and I'm going to write in front of you here. So, right, some of you are telling that. Some of you are telling that it increases stress. Yeah, correct. It increases stress. I agree. You see, dear friends, if you want to increase your stress, keep procrastinating. Which means that don't procrastinate. Stop procrastinating. Okay, what else? What else do you... Yeah, sleepless nights at deadline. Quality of work. Yes, Saran, you got it. Quality of work. What happens? Quality of work decreases. See, does it not happen? This is a good. Please continue writing. No, I'll just keep one by one writing. See, quality of work decreases means at the last moment when you want to do something right, what happens? You cannot put your best. All of us know it, right? We know it, right? We cannot put our best. You know, there's some like, if you are working in an office, you could have done something to sail the level to the excellent level. But because you delayed, you could only do it to the average level. See, this is what happened. Do you want to get this? Do you want this to happen in your life? You don't want, right? So therefore, you should stop procrastinating. I want to give you more reasons. So let me see. Tension increases. No, loha. Yeah. So he says that lose hope. Many people lose hope. Yes, we lose hope. We lose hope. Will I be able to ever do that? Yeah. Panic. people start panicking. Ah, what will happen? What will happen? The deadline is coming. So much of stress, the quality of life, yeah, some of you are saying quality of not just work, quality of life becomes, you know, poor. Do you want that to happen in your life? You don't want, right? Yeah, correct. What happens is unnecessary pressure. Nobody is happy. No, so he's saying that no one is satisfied. No one is satisfied. Neither the teacher is satisfied, nor the student is satisfied. Neither the employer is satisfied, nor the employee is satisfied. You know, neither the husband is satisfied, nor the wife is satisfied. Nobody is satisfied. Exactly. What happens then? Also, telling lies. Okay, very true, very true. People get into speaking lies. But not just speaking lies. Actually, due to the stress of procrastination, many people get into bad habits also. You know, because as you are saying, work pressure increases or study pressure increases, then what do? Many people get into bad habits just because of procrastination. Just because they kept on procrastinating, they went into that trap which I showed you. Discomfort feeling leads to procrastination. Procrastination increases the discomfort feeling. And then the cycle. So do you want all these things in your life? You don't want, right? We can mess up our life. We can say this, mess up our life. Unnecessarily mess up our life. Therefore, I think you have now good and strong reasons that why should you stop procrastinating, isn't it? We want more. Yeah, Sukrut got it. Sukrut says we take shelter of wrong activities. And in fact, no, not only this, quality of life decreases. What it means is many people become depressed. I have seen this in many. I have met thousands and thousands of students till now, you know, probably lakhs. You know, many people get into depression just because of this, that they keep delaying. That's all. They get depressed. I cannot do anything good. I cannot. Even for people also. I have seen even women, you know, they get into this problem of, you know, they're delaying. You know, you could be housewife, you know, you could be, you may have to learn. Say, you just got married and you did not learn cooking before you went into the family. You know, that happens nowadays. You know, I don't know why it happens. Before marriage, the girl should at least know how to cook, right? So if you kept delaying and you went inside the house, you know, and you get some comments from people, you know, oh, you did not make this well, you start feeling frustrated, right? And then you may actually get into depression. I'm not good for anything. I'm good for nothing. This happens everywhere, not just for students. It can happen to everyone. But dear friends, dear students, you know that you have to avoid procrastination for all cost, right? You understand this? I think you don't need more reasons. So let me go ahead. Yes. So if you aligned up till now what I discussed with you, if you understood and you are feeling great, you know, we are doing really great, I'm learning a lot, you know, you're liking it, please type it down. Type it so I know that yes, you are in sync and you are, you know, happy to discuss what I'm discussing further. Yeah, please type it down. If you like it, if you are feeling great, just type it down. It is great. Thank you, Arvind. Thank you, Chetan. If you're liking it, if you're seeing that it is wonderful, we are learning something wonderful, we are actually up to a great discovery. Yeah, I can relate to myself. Thank you, Manshu. It's great. It's going good. It's awesome. Absolutely relating. It's great. It's wonderful. Thank you. Yeah. So whenever we feel good, we should immediately start expressing our happiness. This is very, very important. You know, that's one of the ways you can overcome procrastination, that, you know, you increase your happy feelings in yourself. Discomfort leads to procrastination, but if you're feeling happy, what will happen? You will not procrastinate. That's the reason I made you happy first. Before you enter into the discovery of how to solve it, I'm making you happy so that you will learn it properly. Right in front of you is a statement which I have written, which says one of the reasons which leads to procrastination is to think that we can get success without hard work. I always say this to people. I'll tell to you also. There is only one place in the world where success comes, success and hard work. What is the relationship? What comes first? There is hard work and there is success. Which should come first? Hard work should come first or success should come first? Yes, what is the relationship? Success comes first or the hard work comes first? Hard work has to come first. Is it not true? The hard work will lead to success. Not that, you know, we just keep dreaming and the success will happen. That's not okay. So this is one reason people keep doing progressions. They think that anyway, you know, later on something will happen, some magic will happen, something will happen that I'll get success. But it does not happen. You need to know that hard work has to be there. Hard work has to be there. Then only success will, you know, come. Okay. So one immediate solution I want to give you is here in front of you. This is called as Pomodoro technique. Please know it. see this. This can actually help you a lot. No matter which field of life you are in, a student, a businessman, a corporate, a housewife, anyone you are, this is a technique which you can actually apply in your work. What is it? The Pomodoro technique. What does the Pomodoro technique mean? Pomodoro technique means that whenever you have a difficult, challenging task which you are feeling discomfort by, you know, you can divide the task into small, small groups, small, small chunks. Just spend 25 minutes only on the difficult task. The problem is you're not able to start it. Problem is you're delaying it, right? You're unnecessarily picking up something else to do. So what we say to you, the Pomodoro technique is very famous, world famous technique. What does it say? Decide on a task to be done. That means your important task which you have. Then just set the timer of 25 minutes. You're feeling discomfort, right? You know, it's going to take a long time. It's going to be so difficult. It's good. Either I'll be able to do it or not. You know, okay, no problem. Start it. I'm not going to ask you to do it for more. I am just going to ask you for doing 10, 25 minutes. Dear student, if you are a student, you know, you are talking about mathematics, you're not able to start it. Array, just fix 25 minutes. Take your watch, do the 25 minutes and then see, you know, what happens. 25 minutes you're going to do that and then work on the task until the timer rings and then take a short 5 minutes break after that. I'm going to give you 5 minutes break after that. Okay. And then take a 15 to 30 minutes break. Again, you can give 25 minutes if you want, or after some time you can give 25. What this technique means is you are basically tricking your mind. You are basically tricking your mind. Your mind is saying it's too difficult. You know, it's going to take a lot of tough time from me. I'm not going to be able to do that. Hey, come on, start it. Anyway, if you delay, you know what happens. You know, we have already seen this, all this, what happens to you. You don't want this, right? So what do you have to do? You have also understood that success cannot come, you know, before hard work. Success has to come after the hard work. So let's begin it. And for beginning it, immediate solution. This is not the real solution, but it's immediate. It's going to work for every one of you. Set a timer. Do the action for 25 minutes. Straight 25 minutes, you're going to do nothing other than that important task. You're not going to Google. You're not going to see your YouTube. You're not going to do any other activity, even if it's pleasurable. Nothing. Just 25 minutes for that important activity. You began the task. And you know what will happen? Because you started climbing the Mount Everest, you will realize it was not a Mount Everest, actually. It was not actually a Mount Everest. Mount Everest was only in your mind. Gradually, you start realizing, okay, I'm gonna start it. Then again, you know, it's not so difficult. Even if it's difficult, 25 minutes, you did something for it. And then you can do, you know, work on the task and then take a break. No problem. Take a break. You can go to rest. You can do something enjoyable. You can do something which you like. Again, come back next 25 minutes. I always tell this to the students. So there are many people, some people say that you are distracted, etc. Okay? But I tell you this, even if you're distracted, etc., here is what the solution is. You know, the problem is never going to be solved unless and until you realize that you have to begin it. So begin with the short time, 25 minutes only. Just take your 25 minutes time. With this 25 minutes, just put your all attention on that particular activity. Okay, try it out next time and see what happens. I am going to assure you this technique works a lot. This is you can Google about it also a lot. This is a very, very famous technique which a lot of people in the whole world are using it. Pomodoro technique, 25 minutes. I also say to students in India people are a little better. You know, in the other part of the world, you know, people are more distracted and they have less patience and less tolerance. India people are better. I say, why only 25? Maybe you can take a window of 25 to 45 minutes. Okay? Maybe a window of 25 to 45 minutes. Around that much time, whatever you are comfortable. Maybe you are comfortable 30 minutes. Maybe you are comfortable with 40 minutes. Maybe you are comfortable till 45 minutes. Whatever. Don't take it beyond 45 again. Otherwise, next time you will not do it. The problem is, you will go beyond 45, you will start feeling, aray, yaar, so much more difficult it was, leave it. No. Therefore, small time. Maybe 25, maybe 30, maybe 40, maybe 45, whatever works for you. And don't make it too long, and next time you'll never do. And don't make it too short, and you do nothing. Yeah? So don't make it 5 minutes. Otherwise, you did not do anything anyways. So keep it between 25 to 45 is what I actually suggest to people. 25 to 45 minutes is ideal time of a Pomodoro. Focus all your attention, no matter how hard it is. Karlo bhai, let's do it. Then let's just see what happens. Your procrastination trap cycle will change. You know, your feelings of discomfort towards the activity will reduce. and you will be less under the stress. You will feel more achieved. Questions at the end I'm going to take. But this is not the real solution. I give it to you because it's important to at least do something. Otherwise, long-term solution will work slowly, slowly. But at least for short-term, I give you immediate solution. It works for everybody. It will work for you also. Okay, it will work for you also for sure. Now, let me tell you main difficulty, how it comes, happens. You know, the long-term solutions I'm going to talk about now. This will be going to be more interesting, okay? It's going to be even more interesting because you just don't want immediate. Now, I'm going to define, therefore, what is comfort zone. Let me tell you before I'm defining, my definitions usually are not stereotypical. I don't follow a stereotypical definition. When I wrote the time management book, I wanted to change the dictionary of time management, which means the terms which I am using in my book, I want them to be standardized all over the world. I'm not taking some definition of comfort zone, which you might have Googled somewhere else. No. These are my definitions of what I mean to communicate with you, because words in themselves do not contain anything. How you use those words is where the meaning lies. So for me, I define comfort zone like this. Please see this in front of you. Comfort zone is a situation where a person feels safe. He feels, he may not be safe, but he feels safe. All right. And at ease and in control. That's what comfort zone is all about. You can relate with it. You can understand. It is a settled pattern of thoughts. Here is where the psychology comes into picture. I am very interested in psychology. I read a lot of psychology. That's the reason I read a lot of Vedic Indian textbooks, because I found that they are really amazing. They give so much about the human behavior and psychology. So much is to learn from. If you have not yet read Gita or Bhagavad Puran or the Vedas and scriptures like Mahabharata or Ramayana, etc., I suggest that you probably do that, because so much about human behavior, so much about human dealings and human efficiency and human emotions and how to overcome human vices is given in the scriptures. So I define this that comfort zone is a settled pattern of thoughts and behavior which requires least effort from the person. That's what I define as comfort zone. It's a mental attitude which we have created for ourselves. It's a mental attitude. That is what the comfort zone is. There's no physical zone. It's no physical thing. It's a mental psychological ideology which we have created. Oh, this requires least effort. Okay, this is what I'm comfortable to do. Beyond that is not my comfort. Why? It does not, it requires more effort than what I want to do. Okay, this is what it means. Because before you want to know how to break your comfort zone, you should know what it means. I'll come back to this definition when I'm going to talk about how to overcome it. Okay, so I give you an example of a cage. Comfort zone can be compared to a cage. So here is a cage which I have in front of you. A bird is trapped inside the cage. Now, definitely, the bird is very safe inside the cage. Can you agree with it? Obviously, you know, she's getting her food, she's getting everything, she's having her, you know, nice time inside. She's safe, she's comfortable, you know, she's not getting any discomforts from anywhere, right? But will you say that it is the best situation for the bird? Now, here I want to make you think very deeply. Dear friends, I'm going to break your psychological misunderstanding about life. Please allow me to do that. And I'm going to do it really, really well, because it's important for me to break your misconception right now. Yes, the bird is safe. I agree with it. But is it the most happy situation for the bird? No, definitely not. The bird deserves to fly in the sky. The bird does not deserve to be trapped inside. Is the bird able to utilize her full potential inside the cage? No, right? Definitely, even a small child will say, no, that bird is not utilized. Maybe she's flying, but she's flying only in a small area. Similarly, dear friends, dear students, please understand this. When you create this kind of minimum effort zone in front of you, you are simply misutilizing all your abilities. Your God-gifted talents, which can be explored so much. The flying of the bird, I compare with exploring out your talents. Okay, exploring out lot which is there outside your comfort zone. So this minimum mentality from where we have got, to do the minimum least effort, to do very less, you know, not to do more. Where from you have got this? Who has taught you this? This is not the way life can be led. if you want to do anything good in your life, dear friends, here I am going to be very, very much wanting you to think about this. You have created your own comfort zone. Nobody else has created it. You only have created it. So who will break it? I will break it. No. You are only going to break it. But I will help you to break it. And see, to break, I am going to give you a hammer, okay? And you see, hammer means you have to bang it hard. You know, it's not like, that's how your comfort zone is not going to break like that. You have to bang it hard. And that's why I'm making you think hard. Hey, come on. Every one of us have so much of unutilized potential, which we waste. So much of our life is wasted only because of one reason. Why? We have created this thought process around us of minimum efforts. Why? Why people are thinking about minimum efforts? Why do you have to do minimum efforts in life? Who said that this is the way to live life? Maybe your YouTube videos have told you, but they're wrong. And that's why you should see some of my videos I have given in my YouTube channel. You know, I have given this video about 5 minutes video. Very important. Beware of what you are seeing and what you are watching and what you are reading. So many people are, so much things they are reading on the net, etc. All kachara goes inside. So much kachara goes inside. People form wrong attitudes of life. Who told you that life is about doing the minimum? No, life is not about doing the minimum. Life is to exert the maximum which God has given to us. Utilize your God-gifted talent which you have got. Utilize it to the best you can. Therefore, come out of your comfort zone. Not this minimum action. I'm going to do minimum efforts. No, I will do maximum efforts. Come on. In doing the hard work, there is a lot of satisfaction. And avoiding hard work, you all see this. You know, and this is what you get into. You only told me. I never told. That's why I didn't write this. That is not my opinion. All of you only told me. I just wrote over there. Right? So therefore, you want to avoid this, then you have to also come out of your own comfort zone, the trap which you have created for you, dear friends. Come out of this. Our comfort zone are because of our wrong attitude, and this is the biggest problem, you know, to think that minimum I am going to do, not the maximum. Avoid the hard work, avoid the pain, avoid the difficulty. Please understand, nobody in the world has become successful. Nobody. When you see these big names, right? Oh, Einstein has become so big. Or Newton has become so big. Or this person has become so big. All of these people, they did one common activity. What was that? You guessed it right. They broke their comfort zone. The faster you break your comfort zone, the better your chances of happiness and success in life are. I want you to completely shatter your mentality of doing the minimum. I don't want you to do the minimum. Never. I want to give you an example, right? I want to give you an example here. Dear friends, think about it. When you love a person, okay, so your mother loves you, okay? You love your mother. When you're in front of the mother, you want to do some service to your mother, are you going to do the minimum? Oh, my dear mother, I love you so much, but I'm going to do very little for you. Just little, this much only I can do for you. Bas, it's the Radhani. Not more than that. Least effort I'm going to do. Right? This is not what you're going to do. You're going to say, maximum effort I want to do to please you, to give you happiness. You know, as they say in the Romeo and Juliet, you know, as they say, when the boy is in love with the girl, he says what? You know the lines, right? Aapke liye, for you, I can bring the stars and the moons also. You know, the Romeo and Juliet famous line. What does that mean? It means that even the impossible task also I will want to do for you because I love you. Is it not true? When you love someone, you don't want to do the minimum. You want to do the maximum. Therefore, the real way to live our life is an expression of our love for everybody in the world. When you want to only get success for yourself, when you only want to get success for your own selfish cause and purpose, that's when you want to do the minimum effort. Believe me, this is what psychology says. I have written it in my time management book. You know, this is a lot of people are talking about this, the time management book which I have written. You know, if you want to read it, you can read it. It's a big psychology research, a lot of psychological research which is there. When people behave selfishly, when they want to do activities only for themselves, only for their benefit, that's when they get into this minimum effort zone. I want to do the less, least, not more. But when you live your life with some other attitude, attitude of I want to serve, I want to do whatever, I want to be successful, but for what reason? I want to be successful to do something good for others. I want to increase the happiness of others. That is when which zone you are going to get into? out of your comfort zone, and you are going to not tell me I am going to do minimum. What are you going to tell me? You're going to say I am going to do maximum. What are you going to tell me? You're not going to say I am going to do the minimum or the least, which is where the comfort zone is all about. You know, you are going to tell me I am going to do the maximum. Try it out for yourself. Find out a selfless reason to do whatever you are doing. This is where your intelligence is about. If you can find out a selfless reason, I am going to tell you, you can break through this comfort zone, which is unnecessarily, you know, misutilizing your potential and crippling you of all that good which you can do in the world. Okay, let's go ahead. Yes. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead. And here I'm going to teach you something more here. Five silly reasons why people procrastinate, but they are not the real reasons. Next week, I'm going to talk about even further about if you step out of comfort zone, what's lying out of comfort zone. That's what the next week is all about. Next week, I'm going to talk on Sunday. I'm going to talk about responsibility zone. Okay, I'm going to talk about responsibility zone. You have not heard about this, right? I told you I don't follow any standard textbook, etc. This is all my research work I have done, you know, personally, you know, seen that happening in so many people's life. I've guided so many people. Therefore, I've written this book for after that. Responsibility zone is different zone, which I'm going to talk about next week. If you want to hear on responsibility zone, do join me next week, okay? And call your friends also. So the five silly reasons which people say, some of you also said, were here in front of you. So because the time is over, I want to have some questions and answers. I'm going to stop just in a few minutes, but you please don't leave. One more activity for you. Fear of outcome, perfectionism, rebellion, lack of interest, laziness. These are the five silly reasons people talk about, all due to the comfort zone. Fear of outcome. What if I don't become successful? Better don't start, don't leave. Right? No? But you can do something, right? You may not become number one. You may not become totally 100%, but you can get 80% probably. Perfectionism. If I do this, it has to be the best. So therefore, people don't start on me because they fear that I cannot be perfect. So I say it's okay. The perfection is not in only the result. Perfection is also in the action which you are doing. Because you began the action, you broke the comfort zone. That itself is one of the parts, one of the steps towards perfection. Rebellion. They feel like, oh, I am being told to do something, I am not going to do that. They start rebelling, or lack of interest, as you or some of you said. I don't like this, I don't do that. If you behave like this in your life, how many things you are going to say no to? Because there are many things in your life which you don't like to do, but you have to do. So, of course, I don't say that education should be designed in such a way that all your subjects you should be taught which you don't like to do. But that's not in my hand right now. I'm working on education separately. I'm also talking to the educators. We need to change the way we are educating people. But even if things are not so much to your interest, it's not that you can just drop it. It's not the way we live our life. And laziness, of course, sheer laziness. Let's go to the two minute Google activity. You're going to tell me now, you've heard a lot from me. You've heard about comfort zone. You've heard about the Pomodoro, etc. I've given you techniques and I've given you some long-term thought process also. So why not have an action? I want to take a call for action from you. Therefore, in your chat box, please look at in your chat box here. You have a Google Sheet now. Please fill this. I'm wanting you to take a step now. Please. Every one of you. This exercise, every one of you should do. Because you have come and attended today's program. What are you learning from here? What are you actually getting from here? Action point. I want to see your action. Please kindly click here. Just give your action point here. Because here now you have to think what you are going to do. It's not that you just attend, you just hear and you know you procrastinate. I'm going to do next week. I'm going to see next week. No. I'm going to make you think right now. Right now I want to make you think. Yes, please, everybody. Here is next. So in order to come out of your comfort zone, you need to change your ideologies to come out of comfort zone, because it's a mental attitude. It's a mental attitude. I told you, right? It's an ideology created. There is no physical cage around you. It's a mental cage you are trapped in. Okay, your mental. So where the magic happens is beyond your comfort zone only. Only when you have stepped out of comfort zone, you actually start doing something wonderful in life. Have you not seen it happening in your life? Now tell me honestly, I am sure the reason you know you have been where you are is only because when you started taking some steps out of your comfort zone in your own way. In your life, you have seen this happening. Think about examples in your own life where you stepped out of your comfort zone, where you found something, discovered, but you still said, okay, no problem, I'm going to do it. And then what happened? You actually must have seen some magic happening. You tried, you know, after this class, you try what I've taught you and see where the magic happens. Next week, I'm going to talk more on responsibility zone, which means I'm going to talk about the bigger circle, where the magic happens. Want to please know about that? Come and attend the next week. Hope to serve you again next week. Thank you so much. Great. Have a great time ahead. I hope that this program has helped me, as I told you in the very beginning. Thank you. We'll end the program here. Thank you. Please fill the feedback and give it to us. It is very important. And please go and watch that video on the YouTube. It starts from on my YouTube channel, Amalan Das Official. It starts from Beware. Okay. Please see that video and please do that. Thank you, Mahira. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'll leave from the meeting now. Thank you so much.